we take a look at the world's favorite blue hedgehog in this VFX breakdown. Welcome to VFX Breakdown, the show where we show you how to do your favorite visual effects from TV and film. 2020 brought Sega's biggest celebrity from the console to the big screen. Sonic the Hedgehog was not a movie for everyone, but you have to admit that the CGI was incredible. Ah, no, not that one. Not that one. That's better. 2022 brings us the sequel to this video game blockbuster, Sonic the Hedgehog 2. One of our favorite visual effects from the trailer was the portal entrance of the character Tails.
Hope I'm not too late.
I'm sorry, who are you?
Name's Tails.
We show you how we made our own version of this portal ring effect, and that starts right now.
So we created our backgrounds using an amazing piece of technology called Unreal Engine. So Unreal Engine 5's new nanite technology allows you to make amazingly stunning worlds in just a matter of minutes. If you would like to know more about how we created this background, go to the link in the description. So we'll start with a blank template in Adobe After Effects. I'll go to File, Import, and I'm gonna place my image sequence. So that's my background. There we go. And now since my background does have a little bit of camera movement, the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna camera track this. So I'm gonna go to my effects tab, I'm gonna go to tracker, and then go to track camera. So once the camera is done, you're gonna get a bunch of little 3D points in space. So what this is, it's gonna be where I'm gonna place my ring. So I'm gonna go there, I'm gonna right click and create a solid and camera. So now as you can see, I have a lime green solid and I have my 3D tracker camera. So I'm gonna right click my tracked solid because I don't want that, but I'm gonna pre-compose that and I'm gonna call that ring. Now I'm gonna double click that composition. Now I don't want the lime green square, so I'm gonna delete that. And now this is where I'm gonna bring in my ring. So I'm gonna go File, Import, I'm gonna bring in a PNG of a ring that I made. There we go, that looks super duper good. And now let's adjust that scale, and as you can see, the ring is gonna be stuck in that space. So whenever I move my camera, the ring is gonna stay in 3D space. There it goes, just like that. Looks perfect. But now I wanna give my ring some rotation. So I'll go to my Z rotation, make a zero keyframe, and then a 2 keyframe right at the end, just to give it a little bit of rotation. But now we want it to warp in, so I'm gonna do a scaling animation. So I'll put a scale keyframe right at the beginning till about right where I want it to get big. So I'll make the full size right there and then go to the beginning and place a 0 keyframe. That's a little too slow, so I'll go ahead and I'll adjust really quick. Make it a bit more snappy. Boom, there we go, that's looking way better. Now I'm gonna take both of my keyframes, select them, right click, use keyframe assistance, and add Easy Ease. So Easy Ease is really just gonna smooth out my animation. There we go. That's looking really, really nice. So now I'm gonna go back to my 3D camera tracker and I'm gonna create another solid in that space. So I'm gonna go to the same spot where I made my ring, I'm gonna right click and hit create solid. So now I have a blue little tracked object in there. Now this is where we're gonna make the back of the portal. So I'm gonna pre-compose that and I'm gonna name that white. Now I'm gonna double click that and let's get rid of that blue little square. And I'm going to use my Eclipse tool to create a white circle. Then I'll head back into my main composition. So now this white circle is going to act as the back of the portal. So I'm going to go ahead to where the ring is at its highest, and I'm going to adjust the scale of that white portion of the portal. There we go. And it's going to take a little bit of finicking, so you're going to have to play around with the position and the scale of the portal. Now, it looks as though the portal is kind of not meeting behind the ring it perfectly, so I'm going to go and I'm going to keyframe the position and the scale of the portal until it matches up perfectly with that ring. There we go. Just like that. So if we look at that back, it's meeting up perfectly directly behind the moving ring. So now let's clean this up. We're gonna add some drop shadow to the ring layer because we wanna get a little bit of depth in between. We wanna make it look like it's a portal. So I'm gonna adjust my drop shadow, give it some softness, some distance, some intensity, and I'll make a second one so that the shadow goes all the way around the inside of the ring. That's looking way more realistic. It gives the effect depth. So now it's time to import my footage. I'm gonna go to import file, and I'm gonna grab my footage. There it is. And so now that my footage is imported in my timeline, I'm going to draw a mask around the point that I need where I'm jumping. Just like that. Now I'm going to go over to my keying in the effects tab and pull out an effect called key light and drop that onto my footage. I'm going to select the green and then change from final result to screen matte. Now screen matte, you're going to play with the clip blacks and the clip whites like we've done in previous videos and give a little bit of screen softness. There we go. Now it's not quite as clean as I wanted it to be, so you can adjust it as much as you need to. I'll add a little bit more clip black so that way I get all of my nice details and shadows. That's looking way better. So now that I have my keyed footage, I'm going to adjust the scaling. And I'm going to drop that behind the ring, because that's what we want to do. We're jumping through the ring. So you're going to start behind the ring and end up in front of the ring. So I'm going to start down low, under the ring. Now my head's getting a little bit high, so I'm going to adjust that scaling just a little more. There we go. So I'm going to jump from under the ring, through the ring, and in front of the footage. But it does look like I'm clipping through the ring a bit. So in order to fix that, I'm going to duplicate my main layer of footage and place it in front of the ring. So we're going to do another jump cut. So that jump cut is going to move from the portion of me that is above the ring and finish out the clip in front of the ring. So I'm jumping from behind the ring, and once I get above it, the rest of the clip is gonna finish in front of the ring. Boom, just like that. So now it already looks like I'm coming from inside the portal. But now we gotta clean some stuff up. So I'm gonna adjust my scaling just a little bit back. Now it looks like my head is just going through the top of the ring there. And my foot a little bit. So I'm gonna pull myself up just a little bit so that my foot doesn't clip through. But then I'll show you how to you're gonna fix the clipping through the top of the ring. So I'll adjust my position so that way when I jump, I'm jumping from down below, going all the way to the top, and then falling back where I started. So I'm actually gonna duplicate my original footage. This is how we're gonna clean up the top of this animation. I'm gonna drag it all the way to the top of my timeline. And then I'm gonna take the mask and I'm actually just gonna chop it in half. So now look, bottom of my feet are behind the ring, but my head is above the ring. Super simple. Now my head's not getting chopped off by the ring and I'm finishing in front of the ring. So it totally looks like I went all the way through the ring. Now I'm going to take all my animations, or my keyframes, I should say. I'm going to right click them and I'm gonna add some easy ease from the keyframe assistant. That's just gonna make the animation look way smoother. But we have a problem. My legs are getting cut off at the bottom of the mask. So I'm actually gonna duplicate my background. And I'm gonna draw a mask over the rocks so that way when I land, it looks like I'm behind the rocks. Super duper simple. And I'm gonna place that in the front of my footage. I'm gonna do a little bit of cleanup and I'm going to animate the mask path since the camera is moving. So that way, as I draw closer to the rocks, it looks like my legs are coming down behind the rocks. But I still have a problem. You can still see the bottom of my legs in the beginning of the animation. So what I have to do is I'm gonna get rid of the mask on my initial animation, and I'm gonna draw an eclipse mask. And I'm gonna animate the mask path on the eclipse. So no matter where I go, the bottom of the mask is gonna meet up with the bottom of the ring. Just like that. Clean up the mask on the rocks a little bit. So now if you look, it looks like I'm completely jumping right through the portal. That looks amazing. Now in order to really sell this effect, I gotta make that ring look way better. So I'm gonna go to my effects and presets tab, and I'm gonna choose glow and place it on the ring. Give it a nice orange color, adjust the intensity and the glow radius until that ring really starts shining. And that is gonna accentuate your shadows a little bit, so maybe you wanna bring those down to about 30 or 40% opacity. Wow, that's looking really, really good. The last thing I wanna do is add a new adjustment layer, and I'm gonna rename that lens flare. So as this ring opens, I want the lens to flare a little bit. So I'm gonna go to my effects and presets tab and choose lens flare. And I'm gonna animate what's called the lens center. So as the ring gets bigger, I'm gonna animate the lens center. And since I want it to kind of flare, I'm gonna do an opacity transition. So I'll choose one keyframe at 0 and then one at 100.
If you like this video, be sure to give it a like and subscribe so we can reach future visual effects fans in the future. Now, without further ado, here is our version of the portal ring effect from Sonic the Hedgehog 2.